supply you with breakfast. You are able to get breakfast at the Antarctic Centre on tomorrow morning. Okay.
However, with advancements in technology and expansion of scientific and support activities, impacts on the continent continue to occur and intrude on the solitude. Hundreds of alien species have been identified in the Antarctic, particularly in the sub-Antarctic islands. These aliens are in some cases able to thrive and overtake native species. Please do your part to discontinue this invasion. Before your arrival in Antarctica, please clean your gear carefully. Examples of how not to pack a pest include checking Velcro for seeds and washing your footwear. If you do pack a pest, please report it to your environmental representative right away. To prevent invasion in the future, it is important to identify the vectors of today.
The Clothing Distribution Center for McMurdo and South Pole stations, as well as field camps. Here you will be issued the appropriate extreme cold weather clothing, or ECW, designed for living and working in Antarctica. In just a few minutes, you will receive orange bags containing your ECW clothing. On top of these bags is a clothing form listing your name and the gear you have been issued. The contents of each bag will differ depending on your job and location. Try on all your issued ECW clothing. Make sure everything fits and is working properly. This is both a comfort and safety issue. Tight or ill-fitted clothing restricts blood flow and movement, which will impact your ability to stay warm and to do your job. If any of your clothing does not fit or is damaged, exchange those items now. We can't stress this enough. Get the ECW clothing you need today. There is very little replacement clothing at McMurdo or South Pole stations or in field camps. To make an exchange, take your clothing and form to the exchange counter. The CDC staff will find the right replacement. Once you are satisfied with your issue, repack your bags. One bag has a carry-on tag and one a check-in tag. In your carry-on, pack all the ECW clothing you will wear the day of your flight. Posted some
fast flight to catch that shuttle. If they're picking up 10 people and they say they've got 9 and there's that other person missing, I can assure you they won't wait for you. Make sure you're down there to catch that shuttle at 5:30. Okay, has anybody got any questions?
Good morning. It's 5:17 a.m. on Monday, November 12th, 2012. I'm Jeffrey Donenfeld. I'm sitting in a hotel room at the Elms Hotel in Christchurch, New Zealand. I'm all packed up. There's my carry-on bag and my two pieces of luggage. Watching some Chinese TV here. About to get out of the hotel and get on a shuttle to go over to the International Antarctic Center at the airport. Then board a C-17 and fly to Antarctica to McMurdo Station. I'm super excited. It's been a long time coming this day. So I'm psyched to get out of here and go step onto the ice. Got a little bit of sleep. I'm really excited. Talk to you soon. Alright, here we go into the gear issue room. Where's my gear? And there's my gear that I got set up last night. Now that we're in the CDC, the Clothing Distribution Center, the gear issue room, we put on all of our ECW gear, get geared up for Antarctica, and then sit and wait for our flight to take off on C-17. So, get all this stuff geared up.
I noticed there are some people who have an orange boomerang tag on their bag, plus either a hand carry or a kick baggage tag. Please do not confuse the people around there. They are Kiwi military. Doesn't pay much to confuse them. Yeah, two different types of tags.
Okay, so now I've checked in and I've gotten my departure card to Antarctica. We're all waiting in line here. About to go through security and go wait in the terminal for a little while and until our flight leaves. Alright, here we are in the bus going out on the runway to our C-17 to go to Antarctica.
Yeah, it looks like it.
There you go. There's my ride. Yes.
Video.
Hey guys.
Hey.
Hey. Yo.
Hey, don't tell them so cold before I pay you back, alright?
Okay. I won't, don't worry. Okay.
Are you folks seated in the emergency exit row? Yes, we want to land in. Our emergency exit here in here. To operate this emergency exit, unhook these two hooks on this side. The ladder will fall. There's carabiners on the bottom of the ladder. Hook them into the two D-rings on the floor. Undo each of the four latches.
Nice runway shuttle. Nice runway shuttle. Nice runway fuels.
And this one. The ladder will be up. You'll pass it. There's a lever. Pull it up. Push the door out. And then...
So we're in the Terra bus right now, and we're being transferred from the ice runway, where we landed in the C-17, over to McMurdo, the chalet, which is where they do basic briefing and orientation and everything. And then we get assigned our rooms for night at McMurdo, and then maybe tomorrow, maybe the next day, fly out on the LC-130 to South Pole. It's pretty cool being on this bus.
They go and maintain those windows.
Our ASC, the Antarctic Support Contract Personnel, only at the end we'll have Al Martin speak. So let's start off with Terry.
Anyone new?
It's Tuesday, November 13th, about to board a LC-130 Hercules with a flight from McMurdo to the South Pole. So we're out on the ice airfield here at McMurdo. There's our van, came from McMurdo, which is around the corner there. Power. LC-130, which has both wheels and skis. There's the skis and the wheels. Props.
How are you?
I'm
better in about 20 minutes.
I understand that.
Have to recount, Lance.
Mind if I sit there?
How are you?
Thank you, Ed.
Betcha. How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Good. How are you going to the pole?
I will be there. Oops. Till the end of February.
What are you working on?
I'm going to be a cook in South Pole.
Really?
Yeah.
Good for you, man.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Even funny.
Got one last time.
One left?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
Ready?
Yeah, I thought it could have rolled
pretty good. Hills. Okay. Good to see you, man. Good morning.
Good to see you. Treat the cook good.
Yeah. Yeah.
With the oxygen, we have to use them.
Back at McMurdo. It's really warm here. Winds are unfreezing. Air feels good. Mountains. Lots more people. All sorts of stuff. Really warm so far.
stepping back to New Zealand after living in Antarctica for